This is the I. It's T H I E Y E. This is a I-60 model. There is an I-30 also. You can see it comes in three colors here. I received the black one. This is a 100% waterproof camera. Shoots in 1080p, 60 frames per second, which you can change. It is Wi-Fi. It has full HD, a 1.5-inch display. You can use it in the car. You can use it on a camera. On a helmet. You can use it as a body cam. You can use it just as a regular camera. This is probably my favorite product I have ever received. It is absolutely amazing, and just from the video aspect that it shoots, how quality the videos are, it's also just as good as a regular camera. When you receive the product, it'll be in a pretty stout box. I actually don't know where my box is. There it is. It's going to come in a box like this. It pretty much goes over everything. And if you can see the top there, there's even a mount up there that you can take off and use. I was really amazed at the quality of the box. And it has just about everything you'd want to know about the camera right on the box. Even some pictures there. It shows that it has a 152 degree super view. That's the lens on it. Like I said, it is waterproof down to 131 feet, which is 40 meters. Full HD video, which that will be shot in 1080p at 60 frames per second. The built-in 1.5-inch display. The camera itself, though, is really amazing. And what they give you as far as accessories is another amazing fact. When you first get it, it will be mounted on the box and inside its waterproof housing. This housing has a different back door on it. You can see there's slits in it. You'll get this one, which is fully waterproof. This one's completely sealed. This will be on the camera when you receive it. I had this one on for some reviewing purposes to see if the sound got any better. And please make note that there is going to be a film covering these. And to get it off, you just pull this latch up. But you can see that there is a film on there. I'll start to peel it off. I was just leaving mine on till the very end. But when this is on, it's latched tight. You can still use your power button, which is right here in the front, to power on the camera. This up on top is your shutter button. On the side you have two more buttons, and they are for going through your menus. And the top one activates the Wi-Fi, which I'll get to in a second. And on the side you have a HDMI mini cable port and a USB micro USB power port. They give you a really nice USB cable for charging the unit. I'll go ahead and pop it out for you, and you will see just how small it is. That's the camera itself. You can see it's very, very, very tiny. Like I said, there's your Wi-Fi button noted with the Wi-Fi emblem on it, and an arrow up and an arrow down. That is also covered by plastic, so if you see marks on mine, it is covered by plastic, so no need to worry about getting any scratches on it. Right below where you charge is a SD card slot. There, I popped the SD card out. It will hold up to a 32 gig card. There you can see the nice lens. I'm trying to keep my light out of your face. Yes, but it is a 152 degree lens. You can shoot, record video in 1440p, which is at 30 frames per second, 1080p, which is 60 frames per second, and HD video. It has a 12 megapixel camera, which will shoot unbelievable photos. I posted some in my review. You could also take time-lapse videos, which I thought was really, really cool. The unit itself is like a, it has grippers on the top, but it's like an ABS plastic, so it's very sturdy. It's unbelievably lightweight. And there's also a piece of plastic over the outside lens. I wanted to make a note of that. So be sure and remove all them. You have an LED up here. This houses the battery, which is right on the bottom. I think it was a 12, let me see the exact, I wanted to see the exact size of the battery. It is a 1050 mAh battery. Your recording time's about 90 minutes, and that's shooting at the 1080p. Depends on what else you have as far as what working modes. Because with the camera, you're going to get a ton of different modes you can use. I was pretty amazed. I was petrified at first because of all the different modes that you can switch to. You can see this is just the housing itself. It's got a nice seal around it. These are just, you unscrew this to change different bases. I will go over the bases in a minute. So it's just a thumb screw, very simple. Like I also said, it supports micro SD cards up to 32 gig class 10 or UHS-1. These are sold separately. You do not get a storage card with this unit. I also wanted to make note of that. I kind of prefer that because I'd rather just get a new storage card and use it that way. As far as the iApplication, this is a whole different ball of wax, which I was pretty amazed at. To use the Wi-Fi function, basically you're going to power on the camera and you'll get a little greeting like so. You will hit on the side. I hold it for about 5 seconds and you'll see the Wi-Fi come on. There it says waiting for Wi-Fi right on the screen. Then you'll go to your phone and grab your app that you've already downloaded, called the i, as in just the name of the company. You'll open it up. You don't want to connect yet. You'll go to your Wi-Fi settings, and in your settings you'll see the i right there. You'll connect to that. Hit connect, then you should be prompted with a something saying that you won't have internet. There it is. Just continue yes, and you'll see that I will connect to the camera, and there you go. You can move the camera all around, take you for a tour of the house. You can see me holding the camera holding the phone. But yeah, you can control everything from right here. There's video settings, there's camera settings. It is on video right now. I will switch it over to camera. And then you can pick which camera setting you want to use. I'll just use photo. And you'll hear a beep. I'm trying to move my hand out of the way. And you can just take a picture. And you'll hear it take the picture. Then it's gone back to live, as you can see. And you can view what you just took right here. You can also delete them there. Whatever you want to do is pretty much your options. In the settings, you can see you have resolution. You can change it to time lapse. You can see there's photo settings. It's from burst shots to self timers. There's even a white balance, screen system rotation, the date stamp. You can also format the camera from there. If we go back and switch, you can see there's video settings also in there. And it is very, very well done app. I saw somebody talking about not being able to use portrait and landscape mode, only one, which he was saying you could only use. I think he was stuck in portrait. Well, this is landscape. It works absolutely fine on my phone. I don't know. I'm not sure if he was using an iPhone. I don't have an iPhone to test on. So I cannot test that. As far as switching, it's just simple as that. Very easy to use app. I really, really like this. They definitely did their homework on this. So you can set the camera somewhere and shoot a video without anybody knowing it, like my cat, which you will see. I have posted a few videos of the cat. Sorry about that light glare. I don't know where else to put the light without making it too dark to show you everything. But anyways, you can see the app works great. It is for Android and iOS. It is just called the Nye. If you go to Google Store, it'll just look like that. It's the I, T-H-I-E-Y-E. But you can see how simple it is to connect. You got tons of settings in here. And there's even a little help guide right there you can see. Check for updates about the app and how to connect your camera. And if you hit that, it kind of goes over everything I just did with pressing the Wi-Fi button. Next, you're going to connect your camera using your Wi-Fi on your phone. You can see that I am connected to the i60. But anyways, great application, simple to use. Like I said, it's in the Google Play Store or your iOS store or Apple Store, whatever it's called. I don't use Apple products, so you're on your own on that one. A few of the, to get to the settings, you will just hit and hold the button we use to power on the device. Oops, I powered it off. Okay, well, let's power it back on. And we'll go to a few of the menus. Also, the screen says that I'm shooting at 60 frames per second. It has a little battery guide down there, battery meter down here in the bottom. So that was really nice. Here you can go to your some of your, you can see what you have. If you want to preview a video on the camera itself, you can. You just hit enter, which is the shutter button. And I have no files on mine, so no videos. Hit it again. And you got all your settings in there. Then to move them, you use the up and down button, which is on the side. So very simple. You can see resolution, video quality, looping record, time lapse, exposure, motion detection, white balance, car plate, display car plate, which is nice for driving if you're filming. as a DVR. Quick shooting and the date stamp. To move over, you'll hit the power button again. Or if you want to change one of these settings, you can see that you can right from there. I'll leave mine alone. You'll hit the mode button again, and it'll switch to camera. And in there, you get your resolution, burst, quality, date stamp, white balance, exposure, image stabilizer, photo burst, self timer, ISO. I will go over a few more of those. And then there's just a camera setting itself. You can have it on car mode. There's different sounds you can change. HDR, which I do use. DSP, which is off. The date and time to switch that. You can change the language. You can have a G sensor. System rotation. You can change the light frequency. There's even a system setting, which is all about the camera. You can change the Wi-Fi name if you wish. A Wi-Fi password, you can enter your own, and you can format the camera from here. So very simple to use. You're using these buttons on the side, and the shutter button just activates where you want to go as far as up top. I want to format. No, I don't. So let's hurry up and turn that off. Hold the power button, and that's it. A few of the different options, which there are a ton of them. The camera itself has, like I said, a 52 degree wide angle lens, 1.5 inch display, built-in Wi-Fi, which is great for connecting with the app. There is an up and down zoom up to 4 times, which is going to be when you're in your camera mode or video mode, the buttons on the side. There's pretty much very limited buttons, and it's really nice that way because it covers everything with, you know, one shot. The camera is 12 megapixels. The USB port is 2.0. The micro HDMI port is D-Type. There are 3 colors, a gold, a black, which this is the black, and there's also a silver. The different video resolutions, I kind of wanted to cover this real quick. You can shoot in 1440p, which is 30 frames per second, 1080p, which is 60 frames per second. There's also a 1080p at 30 frames per second, and a 720 at 120 frames per second. I know a lot of YouTubers are using that setting. The video resolutions at such settings at 1440p is 12 megapixels. At 1080p, you're going to have 8 megapixels. And that's 8 megapixels at 60 frames per second. And at 1080p, 30 frames per second, you will drop down to a 4 megapixel. The video codec is H.264, which is pretty much a universal codec. The battery, like I said, is a 1050 mAh lithium battery, which I like because you can also change the battery. You can buy an extra one like I did and have a separate battery waiting for you whenever it is needed. And you can also shoot videos or take pictures while the unit is charging. So I carry a lipstick external battery charger with me in my pocket, one of the little ones. And if I need be, I can charge the camera while I am shooting. The time lapse is 3, 5, 10. 30, 60 second intervals, which is absolutely a blast. The photo burst is 3, 5, or 10 frames, which was also fun. There's also looping record, which is 1, 3, and 5 minutes. So you get multiple modes, everything from looping, time lapse, photo burst, continuous photo, which is great for the car. Inside the package, inside the box, you're going to get the camera, You're gonna get the waterproof housing. You're gonna get what's called the skeleton backplate, which is the one I have on now. I don't know if you can see the slots in it, so it's not 100% waterproof. But the one that comes on the camera is gonna be 100% waterproof, and it's gonna be that. There's no slots, no air holes, no nothing. You're also gonna get the rechargeable battery. And you're going to get a ton of tripod stands, etc., car mounts, helmet mounts. You can see it has nice 3M tape on the bottom. These are very simple to take out. You just squeeze these two clips on the ends, and it slides that centerpiece straight out. That's just one. Here is another one. You're gonna get another one type. It's just a base plate, so you can put whatever you want in it. Again, you got your tape on the bottom. You're gonna get another one. They might all start looking like they're the same, but they are all different. I was really happy to see them even give you a nice cleaning cloth. You're gonna get just a simple mount. They even put their name on it. You're going to get even extra stickies. There's two in this bag. And best of all, you're going to get a nice carrying pouch, drawstring tops on it. This holds every single extra mount, the camera itself, your charging cord, everything you can think of, it holds. I was pleased to see that. Like I said, you'll get the cloth bag and the wiper. This, like I said, is portable. You can mount it to your bicycle. You can take it. There's even a wrist wrap you can use for it. And you might think I'm crazy for saying you can wear this on your wrist or your chest, but it's just so small and so light. It's unbelievable. I was really, really pleased with everything from the portability of it, the fact that it has built-in Wi-Fi. Also wanted to show you there's even a QR code right there, and that will take you to the Apple Store, App Store, I guess they call it. There it is, App Store, or Google Play Store, and you can download their app straight from the box. So I just saw that now. I wanted to definitely cover that. The tripod clamp works absolutely perfect. I have a tripod that's not from the eye, but they do sell their own tripod. They also have their own handled monopod. They have a chest harness you can purchase, and they also have a pet harness you can purchase, which that one I did purchase. I haven't talked the cat into wearing it yet, so stay tuned because that's coming too. I'm going to try and post a ton of videos from these guys. Their camera is simply amazing. It charges very fast. I didn't have any problems with anything other than the microphone. The microphone I have an issue with. I think it needs a little bit of help, but it's very quiet. And if you're in the waterproof housing, it's even worse. I don't understand why, but I do hope it gets addressed in either future models, or I mean, I know there's nothing they can do with this one now. It's not a huge issue for me. It just needs to be updated or improved, I guess I should say. That was my only issue, was the microphone, and to be honest with you, it's not that big of an issue. You still can hear everything. You still know what's going on in the video. Excuse me. In my videos, you'll see one is shot in a dreary, complete blah day, and you can hear the microphone in that, and I do have the protective full waterproof housing on, not the skeleton back. I had this completely sealed back on, so the camera itself was in this and completely sealed, and you can still hear me talking, just not great. So it just needs a little bit of a fix. Trying to think what else. There's just so much. I just hope that I'm covering everything that I wanted to cover. I was actually going to look for the weight. The shipping weight's 1.15 pounds. Now that's because you're getting so much stuff as far as extras. Resolutions we did. The 12 megapixel camera was absolutely amazing. The weight is only 65 grams, so that is crazy. I knew it was light, but I actually didn't think it was going to be that light. I will power it off for a second and show you guys the battery, which is right here inside its little housing. You just get your nail in there and flip that open. There's even a little thing to tug on, and out pops your battery. It is this nice little size here. Like I said, you can contact or go to their website and purchase additional batteries. It just slides right back in, and the back plate goes right back on. So really great job on this. It's very, you're when you first get it, you're gonna think you're not gonna be able to use it because it's got so many options, but once you start running through them, it's very simple. And why it's so simple is because finally a company knows how to make an owner's manual. And before I get too far into the owner's manual, this company is great to talk to via email. They will answer any of your questions. They will help you. If the person is not qualified, they will get the qualified person to email you back. They email you within 24 hours. So they were absolutely wonderful to talk to. Their customer service was just a blessing. I was very happy with their customer service. But on to the quick start guide. Here you will see all the attachments. The switch supports, the adapters, the quick release buckles, the vertical release buckle, the 3M adhesive tape, the flat adhesive mount, a curved adhesive mount, which is for helmets. And if you go further, you will see that you get a appearance area, and it shows you where the lens is, the power mode button, the power and mode button, it's a combination between the two, the shutter and select button, the indicator light, the microphone, the SD slot, USB slot, HDMI slot, the screen size, which is 1.5 and it's an LCD screen. The charging indicator, the status indicator, the up and Wi-Fi button, the down button, and the battery cover. They even show you how to get the app. So really, really detailed, and that's just one side of it. You get a basic operation area, all the accessories that come with it. Like I said, there's a ton of accessories, and there's even an area with their optional mounts, which I was pleased to see because it shows you what else you can get. So great job on the owner's manual, guys. Please never change this. If one thing you'd never change about the camera, it's the owner's guide. It's absolutely spot on. Very pleased with that. Some people might have a little bit of adjustment with the, if you use the GoPro, it does have a different camera angle, lens size. This is 152 degrees, super wide view. I liked it better. I do have a GoPro, and I pretty much use this more than I do the GoPro. One thing, it's priced way better than the GoPro, and two, I love the shooting angle of this. So, just if you're looking for a, I don't want to say inexpensive, because I mean, It's $118.99 at Amazon.com. But if you're serious about your action cameras, I will take this over the GoPro any day of the week. There's many reasons, and the price probably being the biggest one, because compared to the GoPro, I don't see any difference in my actual photography as far as still camera shots or my action video shots. And by action, I mean I have some stuff up with the cat. I haven't done like skydiving with it or anything like that, but I don't see what the difference would be skydiving as opposed to taking a video of the cat running around the kitchen. So I just have no issues with this camera, and I do with the GoPro because of its price. So it's just a great buy in my opinion. Their customer service, like I said, was second to none. I didn't get that with GoPro when I had some issues with their camera. It took about 48 hours just to get an email reply, and the reply had nothing to do with my question, so it just told me where to go next. So I don't know. I was absolutely amazed at the camera. It's so much more than just a action video camera. It's also a camera. I don't have a really good camera. I use my phone camera, and I don't really use my phone camera anymore. I pretty much use this for all my regular stills, which you'll see in the review. I also put some just everyday pictures in there, so you can see the video or the picture quality. Yeah, it's a great camera, great buy. I see there's only 9 left in stock, so you might want to jump on that. You can also click on their link, which is right here. I just highlighted it, and it will bring up more of their products. They also have an i30. I was trying to see if it had it here. I think this is up. Oh, there it is. There's an i30, which is $199.99. So there's also an i30 Wi-Fi cam. It's got pretty much everything you're gonna want: dustproof, shakeproof, waterproof, and it's only $99.99. So great company, great buys. Pick out which one you think you'll be using the most, or what your needs are. I thought the i60 was absolutely phenomenal buy. I highly recommend it. I really hope this video helps somebody make up their mind on what they're going to purchase. In my opinion, it's just a great camera. It does every single thing plus that I would ever want in my action camera. I think another big hit for me is the application. It made it so simple just to take action photos right from using my phone and controlling the whole camera. So great job on every aspect of this. Only issue I saw was the microphone, and it wasn't that big of an issue. So on a final note, overall I just really like the camera. It's 5 stars from me all the way. If you could watch all the videos, if you have a minute, and check them out, see the camera in action, check out some of the photos that I posted, see how you like those. You can post your comments. Our social media buttons are on the website right on the right side there. So like us and follow us. And if you could, subscribe to my YouTube channel. And that way you'll get email alerts whenever I post a new video. We do have giveaways on the site coming up very, very soon. And the only way you're going to know about it is if you subscribe to the site and follow me and subscribe to my YouTube channel, because I announce the giveaways and how to win and what the product is on YouTube. So you're going to want to subscribe, get all that done, then head over to Amazon, follow the link on my website. It'll be right in the bottom. And you will be able to pick one of these up for $118.99. Thank you very much to the I. You guys are great. Keep up the good work, please. Until next time.